Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JRFromPTC. In this video, I'm going to show you how to link a file in Photoshop from Lightroom. That way, any changes made in Lightroom reflect in the Photoshop version. Here we are in Adobe Lightroom, and this is the image that we're going to work with in this tutorial. And I already know what you're thinking. You're thinking taking a file from Lightroom to Photoshop is quite easy. All you have to do is go into Photo, Edit In, and then choose either Edit in Adobe Photoshop or Open as a Smart Object in Photoshop. And that will work. That will take the file into Photoshop in one of two ways. You can open it up as a TIFF file, so you won't have all the advantages of using RAW, or you can open it up as a Smart Object, which will keep it as a raw file, and that's what we'll do. And here we are in Photoshop, and if you look into the layers panel, you'll see that this is a smart object, which means that we can apply a number of non-destructive effects. If you look at the layer thumbnail at the bottom right, you'll see this icon here representing that this layer is indeed a smart object. Now the problem is that if I want to make any adjustments to this file, I can't use Lightroom. If I double click on the layer thumbnail, or in the Properties panel, click on Edit Contents, I will not bring up Lightroom. I will instead bring up Camera Raw. Now, this is not necessarily bad. Camera Raw has pretty much every capability as Lightroom does in terms of developing the image, but you may want to use Lightroom instead for various reasons. So what I'm going to do now is just press the Cancel button, and just to show you, I'm gonna make some adjustments in Lightroom and show you that this smart object is not gonna change. So I'm gonna go back into Lightroom and I'm gonna go into the Develop module. Currently, I'm in the Library module. If I press Ctrl+Alt+2, I will move on to the Develop module. Then I can press Ctrl+1, Command+1 on the Mac to open the Basic panel. And from here, I can make tonal adjustments and I can make temperature adjustments, as well as adjust the clarity, vibrance, and saturation. I can, of course, come into the panel and click and drag on the sliders to make adjustments, but you may find it a little bit useful to know these keyboard shortcuts I'm about to show you. You can use the period key or the comma key to select the different sliders. So for example, I'm gonna press the period key right now, and notice that the tint label is selected. If I press the period key again, exposure gets selected, contrast, highlights, shadows. I'm going down the list every time I hit the period key. If I hit the comma key, I go back up the list. Then I can press the minus or plus signs to adjust the slider. So currently I have exposure selected. If I press the minus key, it's gonna reduce the exposure, making the image darker. Then I can press the period key and go to clarity and increase the clarity to add more contrast in the midtones. And I'm gonna go back up to temperature, and I'm just gonna make this blue by reducing the temperature. So I'm tapping the minus key on the keyboard. And there it is. Now, actually, now that I'm thinking, I'm gonna show you a couple other shortcuts that you might find useful when working with the tonal adjustments in Lightroom. This is the Photoshop training channel, so I'm assuming a lot of you don't know the keyboard shortcuts and all the little tricks that you can do in Lightroom. So if I hover over a slider in Lightroom, I can also use the up and down keys on the keyboard to make the adjustment. All I have to do is hover right over it. So this is actually really useful if you're maybe working on a laptop on a plane or something like that to make adjustments to your image. Another way in which you can adjust the tonal values of your image in Lightroom is by opening up the histogram. So press Ctrl+0, Command+0 on the Mac. The histogram is here, and you can just hover over any area and notice the label here, right here where it says ISO 160. That's gonna be the label of the tonal areas that we're working on. So for example, right here, that's the highlights. Also notice the highlight label here on the slider is highlighted when I hover over that area. So highlights, exposure, shadows, blacks. So right now I'm hovering over the blacks. If I click and drag, I make adjustments to the blacks as well. So that's another way in which you can adjust the image. Obviously, when you're first starting out, just clicking and dragging on the sliders is perhaps the easiest way, To open up the panels, I've been using keyboard shortcuts, but you can just click on the label and it opens. The easiest way to remember is just think of the key control, that's command on the Mac, and then numbers. Histogram is 0, basic 1, tone and curve 2, and so on and so forth, all the way to the number 9. Camera calibration is number 9. So control 9 opens up that panel. And lens correction is, of course, number 6. So control 6, command 6, enable profile corrections, and remove chromatic aberration. Usually I like to turn those on. But anyway, we're just gonna now go back into Photoshop. So you will see that after making those adjustments, nothing has changed in this image. And that is because this image is not linked to Lightroom. We need to link it. Let me show you how to do that. I'm gonna go into File, New, and the file size for this example doesn't matter, so I'm just gonna press OK. Then I'm gonna go into File, Place Linked, and this is where the magic happens. I'm gonna select the raw file, and I'm gonna link that into Photoshop. So just as a side note, we also have the XMP file. That is the side card file where all the Lightroom instructions are set. What that means is that Lightroom doesn't actually edit the raw file. It only creates instructions for how that file is displayed. This sidecar file here contains those instructions. I'm gonna click on the raw file, which is a .nef file, but you may have a different type of raw file. You may have something like a CR2 file, or maybe even a DNG file. And by the way, if you're using a DNG file, then you will not have a sidecar. The instructions are kept within the DNG file. So I'm gonna click on place, and it's gonna open up camera raw, and that's okay. Just click on the okay button. And there's my image here. I'm just gonna hold shift, alt, click and drag on the corner handles just to make it large enough so that it covers the entire canvas. Then I'm gonna go into image, reveal all, so that we reveal the entire image within the canvas. So what happened here is essentially we increased the size of the canvas so that it showed every pixel of the image. We don't need the background layer, so I'm just gonna click on it and hit the delete key to delete it. Notice that the layer now has a little chain link icon here on the layer thumbnail, right here. That is telling us that this file is linked to an external file, which is the Lightroom file. So if I go back into Lightroom and make an adjustment, so I'm gonna go back into the basic panel by pressing Control 1, Command 1, and this time I'm just gonna make the image hotter. And I'm gonna bring the exposure back. And actually what I'll do is I'll just leave it at default. You can double click on this little handle here, on any handle, and it'll reset it. So for example, blacks, double click on it, it resets it. So I'm gonna reset those handles. And you know what, I'll just reset everything. I'm just gonna click on the reset button here, and I'm gonna press Control U, Command U to do the auto tone, which is the same as clicking on this auto button. And then Control Shift U, Command Shift U on the Mac to do a auto white balance, which is the same as clicking here and selecting auto. So those are the changes. And now I'm gonna tell you to press a keyboard shortcut that you probably have never pressed before, in Lightroom that is, and that is Control S, Command S on the Mac. And usually that keyboard shortcut is reserved for saving, and it is for Lightroom as well, but not the way that you're thinking. I'm gonna press Control S, Command S, and this is to save the metadata file, that sidecar file that I was talking about earlier. So I'm gonna press Continue and click on Override Settings. Lightroom saves that file, and if I go back into Photoshop, you will see that this file is gonna change, and it applied the changes we just made in Lightroom. So I'm gonna go back into Lightroom, and I'm gonna make another dramatic change just so that you could see it. I'm gonna make the image really hot, increase the clarity all the way, and vibrance all the way. So now it's really hot. I'm gonna press Control S, Command S on the Mac again to save my XMP metadata file. Then I'm gonna go back into Photoshop. It's gonna take a second, but Photoshop will read that XMP file and the changes will be applied in Photoshop. And you might be thinking, what is the advantage of doing all this work just to get this file to work in Lightroom? Why not just make the adjustments in Camera Raw? Well, there's a lot of reasons. You just might be used to Lightroom better. Even though Camera Raw gives you essentially the same capabilities on developing, you might just have more muscle memory with Lightroom and you can work faster. You may also have presets. So I'm gonna go back into Lightroom and show you how to apply a preset. You can press Control Shift 1 to open up your presets, and these are the presets that I have here. Notice that when I hover over the presets, the navigator window here shows me a preview of what the preset will look like. So let me just choose one of these black and white presets, so maybe this one here. So I can click on it, it applies that preset. I can press Control S, Command S on the Mac to save my metadata file, and then go back into Photoshop. And there it is. Now, you don't have to be a photographer to take advantage of this. If you're a designer, you can take an image, apply it to your design, but make all the adjustments in Lightroom. So it's not just for photographers. And also Lightroom was designed to develop your raw files. So there's a lot of little shortcuts and things like that that really make it easy for you to look at your files as you're working. So for example, if you're developing the file, making tonal adjustments and things like that, you can do things to see your file better. And what I'm going to do now is actually, I'm just going to click on color here just to remove that black and white. We have black and white here. I'm just going to click on color. And what you can do is you can hit the tab key just to remove the panels. F6 to remove the film strip, and Shift Tab to remove even more panels. So I'm just gonna bring those back by tapping Shift Tab on the keyboard. You also have the lights out mode. If you press L on the keyboard, you dim the interface. If you tap L one more time, you completely block it out. And from here, you can hit Shift Tab to remove all the panels, and then you see a large version of your image undisrupted by any of the user interface. So I'm gonna hit L one more time and then Shift Tab to bring the panels back. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. Make sure that you leave all your comments or questions down below. If you create an image using this tutorial or any other of my tutorials, feel free to share it on Instagram with the hashtag PTCVids. I often do a search for this hashtag to see what you're all up to. If I find your image, I will leave you a comment. Also, don't forget to subscribe and click on that like button. If you have a friend who you think will enjoy this tutorial, please share this link with them now. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.